Hi there, everybody. Peter of England bringing you a video today concerning the Trump administration's ongoing battle for the building of the border on the southern frontier of the United States, particularly between United States and Mexico. Now, what I'm trying to do today is there is so much news out there, there is so much hype, there is so much hyperbole, there's so much fake news being put out by the CNN, the Washington Post, the New York Times, CBS, the BBC, most people ridiculing Donald Trump, the Democratic Party, particularly people like Pelosi, Schiff, Schumer, Maxine Waters, and that other gang, basically stating that it's immoral to have a wall, yet they all live behind very, very well-walled enclosures themselves, and saying that it is something that is just not required. Now, as you might be aware, everyone and everything is usually protected by something. The human body is protected by its cellular organic skin covering. Houses are protected by walls. Cars that people travel in have a barrier, which is the shell around which you travel, which protects you. So as far as most things in human nature or the world and the universe are concerned, boundaries, walls, a designated area of operation, a frontier, and a coastal land area or a line drawn on a map define a territory and define, should we say, the ability for that individual, that entity, that geographical area to operate and interact with other similarly enclosed units. So the question needs to be asked, what is going on with this fight and what is going on concerning the Trump administration's 100% support from the United States military and covert organizations within the military to help build this wall? And what it all comes down to, fundamentally, is the battle for control of planet Earth. There are entities, there are individuals, and there are groups who would best seek to control it. And who these groups are, you need look no further than particularly the Democratic Party or the Demonocrats. I'm going to do a follow-up video to this entitled Communism, Fascism, Nazism, and Anti-Semitism, all at the hands of the Democratic Global Reach Masonic organizations that are patrolling and controlling the mainstream media and politics of the planet. But that's for the future, for the next video. What I'd like to concentrate on today is something that many people in the United States and obviously worldwide, therefore, might not be aware of, and that is just what's going on in California. Why is the world's attention, as far as this border wall, being brought down on California? Now, for one thing, many of you might not know that California has the largest debt burden of any other of the 50 states of the United States. And this is because of the controlling families that run and operate their criminal, mafia-type cartel in California. The amount of debt in California is astronomical. Put conservatively at a pensions liability of $1 trillion and a budget deficit of around about $1.2 trillion, puts it in about $2.2 trillion, which is approximately 10% of the entire United States debt, national debt. So, what's going on there? With all that money having been squandered, used, utilized, why is it now that they still claim that they have monetary problems and need greater assistance for budget problems when it comes to the recent fires in California? Could these fires have been lit deliberately by crime families who are looking to override the prime budget mandate ceilings where they require emergency funding? Very much, most certainly. Now, look at the people who are giving the Trump administration, this outside administration that have come in to try and take control and drain the swamp, which is Washington politics. Look at the people who are giving Trump the hardest time. People like Mad Maxine Waters, California. Chuck Schumer, California. Adam Schiff, California. Feinstein, California. Pelosi, California. These are senators and Congress people who have a foothold and a long-established controlling family interest in California and control. Many of you might not realize that good old Nancy Pants Pelosi is part of her maiden name was D'Angelo. She is part of the D'Angelo crime family of California, who actually then married into the Pelosi stronghold. I'd just like to show you or talk to you a little bit about some of the crime family connections there. I'm going to go first of all to a map here. These connections in California, quote, date back at least 80 years to when Jerry Brown, he was the governor of California, and Pat Brown ran for San Francisco's district attorney, losing in 1939 but winning in 43, with the help of his close friend and Gavin Newsom's grandfather, businessman William Newsom. Now, you might not heard of the Newsoms, but if you actually go and have a look at the families of Brown, Pelosi, Newsom, and Getty, you will see that this is a family or a series of connections that are connected through blood, marriage, political donations, and, as I say, intermarrying, and also business relationships. So please don't think for one minute that Nancy Pelosi and the Schumers and the Schiffs and the Maxine Waters are reaching out with open arms and compassionate intentions for allowing these poor immigrants and these so-called asylum seekers to cross the border into the United States so that they can be cared for, nurtured, looked after, well-educated, just the opposite. Start to dig and have a look what their interests are, what their financial collateral is, and in every single situation, if you take their annualized salaries, multiply it by the number of years that they've held office, you come to a massive deficit, is a coordination between what they've received in pay and what their worth is. In every situation, it is worth millions and millions is what they have in their estate. So these are the crime families. These are the people who are operating and want the border open. And they don't want that border open necessarily to just protect the drug cartel monies and drugs, all sorts of, from cocaine, marijuana, various amphetamines and barbiturates that are being brought into the country. If you look at the trial recently of El Chapo, El Chapo's trial, normally, if it was someone like Michael Jackson, if it was O.J. Simpson, that trial was broadcast by mainstream media every single day, day in, day out, week in, week out, till it ended. Every nuance, every court procedure, every smile or frown was broadcast. But El Chapo, the biggest drug lord for operational cartel narcotics trafficking in the world, based out of Mexico, didn't get hardly or didn't receive any coverage at all. Why was this? It was because he was naming names. He named the Pelosi's, he named the Schumer's, he named the agenda. But more importantly, it was not only the drug trafficking. The main thing that the Democratic Party are covering is the human trafficking angle, where they are bringing human traffic slaves and sacrificial bodies into the United States to appease their satanic agenda of worship, idolatry, and slaughter in the name of the Baal, Moloch, Luciferian agendas to which they serve. So please do not underestimate. These people are inherently, deeply, and brutally evil, and they do not have your best interests at heart. If I was an asylum seeker, if I was a potential illegal immigrant or legal immigrant, I would make sure I stayed well clear of these people, because as Alexandria Octavia Cortez has recently said, for anybody voting for this emergency bill, that what she was going to do is try to encourage stroke political activists to target them. Maxine Waters has stated the same. Eric Holder, the ex-attorney general, has stated the same, as has Pelosi. Basically, what they're saying is if you don't agree with them, then hit the road, Jack. You're not wanted in town. These people are despicable, evil. They want a return of power at any cost and every cost. And as very soon, with a deadline coming around about March the 18th or 19th, at the outside, the revelations about who was involved in the illegal FISA warrant obtained by lies to a FISA court judge in the United States break, we will see a global implication. We will see the house falling down in the United States, because everyone from Hussein Obama to Michael, his transgender boyfriend, through Pelosi, through Schiff, Schumer, Comey, Clapper, the entire Brennan CIA operative network, and the mainstream media, from Jim Acosta through to all of the major news platforms, are going to be implicated in the FISA cover-up. And the only collusion that was ever in place and is verifiable is the collusion that Mueller and his team, with Comey's help and the likes of Strzok and others, have been put into place to cover up. And that is the Clinton family's collusion with the Russians on the Uranium One deal and many other deals. So please stay tuned for the next video, which is even going to be more outreaching and covering topics that you really need to start to get a hold of. And I'll just put a teaser in here. If you don't understand the extraterrestrial agenda, the extraterrestrial cooperation between various factions within the covert and deep state government and off and on planet entities, then you will never figure this out in 100,000 reincarnations. And this is one of the reasons that Donald Trump has instigated this Space Force, which seems to be a very left field thing to have done, but more talk on that for next time. So please like, subscribe, and above all, circulate the video to other people that you might think would find this of interest. So I know this has got an American bias. I don't apologize to the people who watch this from Germany, through Europe, from the United Kingdom, because what is going to happen in the United States has a domino reactive force, because the United Kingdom government, Theresa May, MI6, Christopher Steele, all supported the collusion and the fabrication of an illegal dossier and illegal activity to survey a United States citizen contrary to the law. And if that doesn't count for anything, then throw out your constitution and say goodbye to your freedoms and the presumption of innocence. So, thank you very much. Look at the links below. Peter of England signing off.